Chip, so the video I have for you today is a little bit of a bitching session about my 7-string. This is a Ibanez RGIR237FELBK. That's his full name. Ibanez Iron Label 7-string. Active EMG pickups. This thing is like, it's barely a year old. It was straight out of the box. I bought it brand new for about $1,200 with a case. Now, this is one of the things that pissed me off about it. I don't know if you guys can see that, but can you see those marks around the screws holding the neck in? You see those marks? You know what those marks are? Those marks are raw wood. So they didn't even fucking paint it properly, man. You know? You pay all this money for a guitar from apparently one of the best guitar companies in the world, and look at that shit. They haven't even painted it properly. They haven't even put any fucking work, you know, like effort in there. I mean, what? Is it because I'm a lefty and I'm the minority, so you feel that you're justified not to paint my shit properly? You know? Because I bet you almost every fucking right-handed guitar wouldn't have stupid little defects like that. And this is stupid and trivial because it's Ibanez. They're supposed to be making guitars for, what, mean cunts like Steve Vai and Joe Satriani and all that, but I don't know. Shame on you, Ibanez. You make out like you're a wicked guitar manufacturer. And look at this. Oh, shit. You fellas can't even paint things properly. Oh, and guess what? This thing's never hit a stage in its life. Never, ever, ever been on a stage. It's only been in a recording environment. And it's literally been to like 4 band practices. And guess what? There's another thing that happened a couple of days ago. My little tab for my battery is fucked. So this thing here, I go put the battery in. Go close the lid. Go play it. You know, and because they're using cheap and shitty battery terminals, that battery terminal there, when it wiggles and it's plugged in, is going to determine how loud my guitar is going to be. So, you know, for those of you looking to invest into a new guitar from Ibanez, I suggest you pull out the cutty comb and you check it through thoroughly. Don't do what I did and just assume that, oh, well, it's brand new out of the box, it should be perfect, because in the real world, they're not. Actually, they're far from it. Shame on you, Ibanez. I paid a lot of money for this, and that's the kind of half-assed workmanship that I get in return for giving you my money. Shocking. Shocking as.